Joining me live in the Headlines Today studio now, Dr. Sambit Patra of the BJP, who will be giving us his perspective. Also with us is our National Affairs Editor, Javed Ansari. Also joining us is Praveen Singh, member of the Aam Aadmi Party. We'll get a perspective from him as well. Javed, I'd like to quickly come to you first. You heard the speech that was made by Arvind Kejriwal. The tone, you know, the studied tone that he's been using all this while has worked for him. No reason why he needed to change that. A lot of rhetoric, a lot of innuendo as well. But clearly saying, you know, before he made that, before the vote was actually passed, he said, this is not about support for parties. This is about support for the Aam Aadmi and a support for issues. A very cleverly worded appeal there.
Very cleverly worded, and he stuck to his guns. He stuck to the straight and narrow path, which the Aam Aadmi Party has been talking about. There weren't too many rhetorical flourishes, at least from in Mr. Kejriwal's speech.
Yes,
we saw that the leader of the opposition, by and large, it was sans any acrimony, sans any bitterness, and a lot of things. You know, the BJP did vote against, but certainly didn't ask for a division.
Yes.
And then you saw you know, MLAs from across the floor going and congratulating the new chief minister.
Yes.
It was a foregone conclusion once the Congress decided to formally put its weight behind the Aam Aadmi Party. There wasn't too much of a doubt, and that's what's happened. The results are on predictable lines.
Praveen Singh, you know, things going pretty smoothly as far as the Aam Aadmi Party is concerned, on expected lines as far as the Congress's support is concerned. But, you know, like several people are saying, you know, this could be just the beginning of much more difficult and turbulent times. The Congress may have supported you, you know, issue-based support as far as this government is concerned. But the Congress is by no means the Aam Aadmi Party's friend, your party's friend.
Well, I think it's a moment which goes beyond words, and I think you used the word that Arvind was very cleverly worded speech, but actually I would say it was a very straightforward thing, which is what our politics is about. And I think sometimes when we get into these debates, we tend to extrapolate from the past and we say that Congress is not the friend and BJP is not the friend. But I think we are talking about a new way of doing politics. And if you look at Arvind's speech, we are basically saying these are people's issues. And as leaders, as people who, as representatives of the people, these are the questions we have to answer.
Mm-hmm.
So I think while we live in times of cynicism, but I think let's be more optimistic. Maybe this will be the beginning of new ways of evolving solutions for people. So BJP maybe not seeing itself as BJP and Congress not as Congress. I'm not saying these things are going to happen overnight, but I am far more optimistic about how things will go in the future. So I would like to say that actually on this issue.
Sambit, I'd like to bring you in here. You know, beyond all the cynicism like Praveen was just mentioning, is there any room to subscribe to a level of optimism? Is there anything about what Arvind Kejriwal just said in his speech that arrested you, or do you believe that it's all rhetoric?
No, look, I mean, first and foremost, let me congratulate my fellow spokesperson, Mr. Praveen, over here. They have formed the government after all. But as you rightly pointed out, everything was on the expected lines. And I believe personally that the lines were drawn well before the elections also. In one of the interviews to one of the major channels, I remember the incumbent chief minister then, Mr. Sheila Dixit, had a drop of words, and the words were, well, yes, we can come together and form the government.
Yes.
Though the counterparts, I mean, the AAP right now, till the elections, was swearing on the children that they would not go in for any kind of support, nor would they extend any support. In fact, Shiv, the recent rounds about Mr. Rahul Gandhi's anger, if you remember, Mr.
Yes.
Arun Jaitley had come up with a fantastic word, and that is contrived anger. Somehow in this whole scenario that I saw in the assembly today, I feel like I should also coin a term called as contrived intention of fighting against corruption. Today, the ones who are trying to fight against corruption and the ones who are corrupt are married together with a relationship of convenience, because the Congress, after having drubbing so
okay.
low to the 8 MLAs, needed a breathing space,
okay.
which they got, and the R party needed to represent itself in the national scenario, which, as you rightly pointed out in the opening, the whole of the country is watching this today.